Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about how to pass code without meeting prescriptive R value. Now I know what you're thinking, but there's no witchcraft or sorcery here. Using the performance method instead of the prescriptive method is very common, and it's becoming more and more often used with today's construction standards. Now there's really two common ways you'll see most often. One is a REM design, and another is a RESCheck. They're very similar. They're both programs that you put in all the data from your project. If it's a house, you'll put in the square footage, surface areas, windows and door ratings, as well as insulation values and such. And you put in all this data, and the program will tell you if your house is efficient or not. It's a pass or fail. And a RESCheck is very similar. However, a REM design is very, very detailed. It actually requires a certification and will oftentimes come with a cost as well. So if you have a new house you're looking to have done and you want a REM design put together, you want that report because it's very detailed. Like I said, you'll have to get a hold of someone that's certified. You'll have to give them a lot of information. Usually blueprints are the best way to do that. And they'll put that report together for you. But again, it will come with the cost most of the time. Now, RESCheck. This is a typical thing that's found for most contractors. It's, again, just a program that you put data into and it gives you a pass or fail for your project. However, it does not require nearly as much information as a REM design, and anyone can do it. You can go right on to the website and you can put everything into the program and it will tell you if your project passes or fails based on performance efficiency. So again, you'll see that probably more often just because it's more available and you don't have to get someone that's certified to do it. But you can print out that report from either way and you can give that to your inspector and you can say, you know, I put all the data in, this is what we're building, this is what we're using as far as materials. They'll review it and accept that yes, this does meet code based on the performance method. Now, I also want to add, if you're going to do any project using the performance method instead of prescriptive measures, it's crucial that you keep constant communication with your inspector. A lot of inspectors throughout the whole country are not nearly as familiar with performance methods as we may think. It's still new to some contractors. So again, that's not a slight against inspectors. It's just new for a lot of us. So again, you want to keep constant communication with them. Let them know, hey, I have this part of the project coming up. This is what I plan on using. I'll be doing a REM design or I'll be putting together a RESCheck for you. I'll send you over the report as soon as it's in. And you want to do those things well before the work is done. That way, if there's any question or confusion, you can handle that before anything is put in place on the project. Hope this information was helpful to you. Like the video, please leave us a comment. If you have a project coming up and you're wondering, you know, will this pass code or is there a different way to do it? Please tell us about it. We'd love to hear from you. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and make sure you hit that bell so you see all of our notifications. Do you need a last minute gift for a loved one? Share one of our videos. It's the gift that keeps on giving.